the middle of the night, and this song came out of my spirit, I need you. And I believe that the only way to stand strong now is to need God. I don't know what you need, because I still see so many people struggling with so many things. But if trouble is to break out, everybody will abandon everything, and you will start to run for your life. Today I bring you good news. And I believe, God, that what every person should desire and what every person should need is the one that is the giver of life, that gives life abundantly. Apart from air that we all take, two things are most important to stay alive. One is water, and the next one is food. In the book of John chapter 4, he spoke of himself as the living water. And in the book of John chapter 6, he spoke of himself as the bread of life. I believe, God, that you cannot stay alive without Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And so when you begin to sing this song, make it a prayer and invite him. Let him be the one that you are hungry for today. Maybe you still came here with little problems, because God has helped us thus far. But I look out for those who shall be hungry for him, those who shall be thirsty for him, those who know that he's the bread that we breathe and he is the life that we live. Tell him that you need him. Make it a cry.
Oh, bless me now, my Savior, I come to you.
Are you coming? Are you drawing closer? Begin to draw closer to him. Who can say, who can take it?
Every hour.
Draw closer, start coming, bring your heart.
Oh.
Psalm 63. This is the time that the church needs to rise up to the place to know what we need to be able to discern the things we hear and the things that we listen to every day. Come this morning, I say, God, I need you. And I began to pray that the church will need him again. I began to say that three things that everyone needs. One is the air, next is food and drink, and Jesus is the life, which is air. And Jesus is the bread of life, according to John chapter 6. And is the living water, John chapter 4. Who do we need? We need Jesus. David's prayer, he began to say, I need you. The prayer and cry of David in verse 1, Psalm 63. Let's start from verse 1. I want to return us to the path of righteousness and to the path of prayer, somebody, this morning. David woke up and said, oh God, you are my God. Early I will seek you, my soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. When you find yourself in a dry and a thirsty land, when a people, a nation find themselves in a place where they are no longer secure, what do they do? The prayer and cry of David in verse 1 reminds us of a sin which probably all of us have seen in the past few months in this nation. The only thing that can satisfy us right now, in the midst of the hard times that we are, things are hard if you don't have God. But if you have God, He will satisfy you. Because He will remain the bread of life for you. He will remain the living water. And He will begin and continue to be your bread unto eternity in Jesus' name. Can I hear you believe in amen? Can I hear you believe in amen? If you actually believe, can I hear you loud amen? In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This time when David wrote this, one of his sons had turned against him and was trying to take the kingdom and his life from him. Wickedness did not start now. Whatever we are facing, David faced it. This time it was from his own household. The kingdom was at stake in the hands of his son Absalom. And because of the threat, David had to flee the city of Jerusalem in a hurry. Once again, as in the years before David had been running from Saul. This time he was not running from an enemy, a king. This time he was running for his own son. In the face of this crisis, there was one thing that he could identify. I wonder whether we can pray like this. Oh God, you are my God. Can you join me pray this prayer right now? If you have not prayed it somehow, and you are not praying it, can you start again to pray? Oh God, you are my God. Can you pray it? I need you. God. David knew where to and from whom to turn to in times of trouble. And not just in times of trouble, but in times of peace and also in times of plenty. Do you think that at that time that David was alone, that he didn't have friends to come? Or do you think he didn't have people to depend on? No, he did. But David knew where his satisfaction and deliverance will come from. And I've come to announce to us today that our satisfaction and deliverance is coming right through and coming through the Lord. He's the one that will meet our physical needs and our spiritual needs today. And I believe God that He wants us to be fixated on Him right now. He wants His people to begin to pine for Him. He wants the people to begin to return back to Him. At that point, David was tired. How come my son Absalom, the one I love, the one I forgave, the one I brought back again, be after my life? He was now done with all the betrayal of men. If man has not betrayed you, you will be betrayed again. Not until you wake up in the middle of a night and then you begin to think. Some of us think that our father, our mother, our brother, and our sister, our best friend, our boss in the office, our colleague, our pastor cannot betray us. Wait until that hour of betrayal comes. You cannot put your trust in man. Every man that has this flesh, you see this dust, can betray you anytime. It all depends on what is going on and what is at stake at that time. My cry this morning is that we must take away our confidence in flesh. The arm of man will always fail. Flesh will always fail. Not that your father or your mother or your sister wants to betray you, but a time comes when their own them again. It all depends on what is at stake. If the family really needs money and a very rich man comes, their mother can turn at that time and say, just marry him, it doesn't matter. You can go and be a second wife. What is wrong with that? When your sister really needs help, your sister can say, why not just accept him? Let us get this job. After all, it's just to go and sleep one time and come back. Because your sister at that time, her own desire is stronger than your own faith and desire to serve God. Fathers have turned in their wives at critical times. If you have not been betrayed yet, maybe the person you have trusted have not come to the time of point of deciding whether to go forward or to go back. But there is one that will never betray you. If you can actually be able to allow this flesh, this carnality, the work, some of us daily are betrayed because we can't leave the work, even though that we know that we sin daily in it, because we know that that is the only hope of eating. But every day we are sinning on the work. But not until everything is gone. Because one day that work will pass away. The family will pass away. The children will pass away. I know women who have to do all manners of things to train the children. And the children will grow up and they will abandon you and say, well, we didn't ask you to do that. We are sorry. And then they marry their wife and close the door and say, mommy, you can't come. Except if my wife allows you. And now you have to go and pay consequence for the sin and the things you did. And I tell you sincerely, this was the state where David was. And he began to say to himself, oh God, you are my God. Early will I seek you. I will wake up in the morning and start seeking friends. And start looking for who to call to give me the latest news. The reason is because our soul does not thirst for him. If your soul surely thirsts for God, when you wake up in the morning, the news will not be the first thing that will determine what your heart will go and how your heart will go. He said, my flesh longs for you. What does our flesh long for? One of the strongest desires, the two most desire, strongest desire on this earth. I repeat, every human being has two most strongest desire. One is life, the second is what? Sex. These are the two most strongest desire in every human being. Every flesh longs to be alive. And the next is sex. When your flesh desires sex more than it desires God, even when you have made up your mind to serve God, it will still be difficult for you. Let alone food, let alone drink. Those ones are lesser. Some of us today, these are the battles that are before us. And David was saying, in a dry and thirsty land. He was in the wilderness. He was in that dry place. He was thirsty, where there was no water. Then he said to himself, even the desire for water is not stronger for my desire for you. Even the desire for food, there's no food here. It's not stronger for my desire for you. Even the desire for sex is not stronger for my desire for you. One thing the enemy has done is to bring so much corruption to humanity that the desire for God has become so weak. Desire for the word of God has become so weak. And as we begin to worship again, let's pray. Let's ask God everything that is taking away his desire in our life. May we be delivered today. Whatever it is that is attacking the spirit of God, the desire for God, that the flesh, the desire for the world, the desire for popularity, the desire for accolades, the desire to be known. Everybody likes to be liked. Everybody likes to be liked. And that's why we go on Facebook and the desire to be liked on the Facebook, the desire to be liked on internet, the desire to be liked here, to be liked there is heavy on us. Everybody desires to be liked. But we're going to pray today, Lord. Every desire to be loved by husband, wife, children, to be loved by mentors, to be loved by the leaders, to be loved by those that follow us, to be loved by men. Let them no longer be stronger than our desire for you, than our desire to come into your presence. Can you pray that prayer? Ask God, today every desire that draws you away from me, that I desire whatever it is more than I desire the word of God, than I desire your presence, than I desire to know you. Father, deliver me from those desires this morning. Deliver me from those desires that are blocking my desire for you. In the name of our Lord Jesus, that I can again begin to desire your presence, so that I can hear you and I can know what you desire. Let the worry, not the anxiety of marriage. I want a husband. I want to have this. I want to do that. Ask God today, deliver me from the desires that are standing against my faith, against my trust, against my desire. Ask God today, deliver me in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
I need every hour.